Hello, my dear students. Today I am going to share with you the tips for solving a case study. Case study is almost like asking all the question papers. So today let us see how should be our approach for solving the case study. Now, before you solve a case study, there must be some imperative things that you have to keep in your mind. The first one is you must be clear with the subject concepts. When you are trying to solve a case study, you must be first of all clear with the subject concepts. Unless you are not clear with the subject concepts, you cannot solve a case study. For example, we have different concepts, different theories from the different subjects. If I talk about HRM and OB, we have two factor theory, we have Maslow's need theory, we have Vroom's expectancy theory, equity theory, we have like theory X and theory Y. We have different training requirements, methods of training, pros and cons of those training methods. Unless you are not clear with these concepts, you cannot solve a case study. So please make sure, first of all, you should understand the subject properly. Then the second one is psychological barrier. This psychological barrier is one of the biggest problem that most of the students face while they solve a case study. In psychological barrier, what happens? Most of the students, they think they cannot solve a case study. So they will never see at the end of the question paper, because mostly the case studies are asked at the end of the question paper, and they carry the maximum marks. These case studies, they have the maximum weightage in the question paper. But here only students, what they do, they skip it because they have that psychological barrier that we are not going to solve this case study because they think they cannot do it. That is the main reason. So this barrier has to be, it should be overcome by the students. You should have that trust in yourself that yes, you can solve the case study. Then the next one is always start from the bottom. Now, when any case study is given, mostly if I talk about the closing case studies, you will be given questions at the end, right? There will be some questions, question number one and question number two. If you read the question number one, you can easily find out the answer of that question from the case study. Then question number two, simultaneously you can do the same, but make sure you are reading the whole case. Now I am not telling like you have to read the question and directly spot the answer of that question from the case. No, even then you have to read the whole case study. Then one more thing is here, read and reread the case study with silent mind. This is very important. You should read and reread the case study with silent mind. All your concentration on the case study, all your focus on the case study. You should, when you read for the first time, you will understand, say for example 30% or 40% or 50% of the case study. When you read it for the second time, you may understand 90% of that or 100% of that case study. You will understand the gist of this. That is why reading and rereading of the case study is important, because you would be given some problem in that case study and you have to find out that problem and later what should be your approach to solve that problem that you have to find out. So these are some tips before you solve your case study. You have to keep all these things in your mind. Now we'll start with the stepwise, the steps which we need to take into consideration while solving a case study. The first one here is situation analysis, or you can say the summary of the case. When you are reading the case study, you are understanding the case. You are understanding the case when you are reading it. After that, what you have to do, you have to write the summary of that case study, or I can say the factors of that case study. This is the first step. You have to write down the same heading while solving the case study. Write either situation analysis or summary of the case study. And this summary of the case study should be equal to 1/3 of the case study. Now say for example, if the total number of lines in the case study is 18. There are 18 sentences in that case study. So one third of that is how much? It is 6 sentences you have to finish your summary, right? Then the second one is formulation of the problem. As I said you, when you are reading and rereading your case study, make sure you are understanding what problem exists in that case study. This is very important because most of the case studies are problem oriented. So you have to find out, you have to trace the problem from the case study. In case if you fail to formulate the problem, or if you are unable to find out the problem from the case study, you cannot solve the case study then properly. Your approach will be wrong. Then the second one is causes of the problem. Now if any problem exists in the case study, for example, decline in the sales, profitability is decreasing, employee turnover is increasing, employees are not satisfied, EPS of the company is coming down, dividend per share is also coming down, these are the different problems you can find out from the case study, fine. Then what are the causes for that? If the sales are declining, what are the causes for that? If the employees are quitting the job, what are the reasons? What are the causes for that? All these causes you should find out when you trace the problem. Fine. Then the next one is facts and figures given. Now, when the problem exists, when you have find out the causes of that, there would be some facts and figures given in the case study. Right? You have to make a note of all those factors and figures. For example, the sales of the company from the past 5 years were this. They will give you some statistical data, right? So that statistical data you should understand and interpret it. You have to analyze that. Those factors and figures are given for what? You have to understand it, and then you have to go further. Then the next step here is assumptions. Now see here, all the time every information will not be given, it will not be mentioned in the case study. Sometimes you have to assume yourself, some things have to be assumed. For example, they are talking about employee dissatisfaction, but they have not mentioned what are the reasons for this. Say, and in that case also, let us say if they have mentioned one or two causes for the dissatisfaction, rest you can assume why they are dissatisfied. They have mentioned only salary, other things they have not mentioned. You can assume them, like promotion is not given on time, like incentives and perks are not given, right? Working environment is not proper, there is no work like balance in that organization. These all you can assume, but make sure you cannot assume too much, because too many assumptions will spoil the sanity of the case. So that should not happen. You can assume. Then the next one is you have to go for the SWOT analysis of the organization. Here mostly the SWOT analysis, if we talk about SWOT analysis, we have strength and weakness, we have opportunity and threat. SWOT analysis mein jo strength and weakness hai, these two are internal to the company, whereas opportunity and threat, they are external to the company. For example, if we talk of the strength, strength of the company is brand value. The good value of the company is, it is the strength. It is a strength. Customer loyalty, it is the strength of that organization. Now, if you talk about the weakness, some companies, they have weak HR planning, right? Then HR planning is not good. Fine. So this is the weakness of that organization. If you talk about the opportunity, in opportunity, if I talk about, like, if any organization is catering to the domestic market, it can go to the international market, they have an opportunity. If they are catering to the rural area, they can go to the urban. If they are catering the urban areas, they can shift to what? The rural areas. This is, they have that opportunity. Then when we talk about the threats, the permanent threat for the organization is the rivalry, the competition from the competitor. So this we have to understand when we are solving the case study, and hence we should make the heading of this also when we are addressing a case, that is SWOT analysis. After that we have generation of alternatives. Now we have a problem, right? Every problem has the solution, and there is no one fixed solution to a problem. What we can do, we can generate n number of alternatives to address that problem. Fine. So once we are done with that, what we are going to do? We are going to evaluate all those alternatives. If we have selected now four alternatives, now what we are going to do? We are going to evaluate them, because we cannot select all the four alternatives to address that problem. No, we cannot do that, right? We have to select out of all those alternatives, we have to select the best one, right? We have to select the best one. Then selection of the best alternative. Once we are evaluating all those alternatives, we will come out with the best alternative available. Once we are done with that, what we are going to do? We are going to develop implementation plan, right? So when we have one best alternative available, how are we going to implement it now? For example, there is decline in the sales. This was the problem. You have developed many plans, like reduce the price, fine, go for heavy advertisement and promotion, right? Or give some discounts. So these are different alternatives you have selected to boost your sales. Now out of these three, what you can do? Let us say you have selected the best alternative out of these is to go for the heavy promotion or heavy advertisement. So you have to now develop a plan how you are going to advertise. That advertisement plan you have to develop now. Fine. Then we are going for suggestions and conclusion. Once we are done with the implementation plan, we will get the results. Based on that, what we are going to do? We are going to suggest the company. What we are going to suggest? Whether they should stick to the same plan or not. Fine. Then we are going to conclude the case study. That is the last part of the case. Thank you so much for watching this video.